where we welcome you to Bethel Tabernacle AME Church. We're the church right here in Crown Heights and in Weeksville community, where we're bringing the gospel of Jesus Christ to you in your homes during this season. We want you to be encouraged. We want you to know that we're here to support you and your families through this season. So I ask you right now to go and call somebody, notify somebody, share this message. You got to share it. Go into the comments section right now. And you know what I always say from since the second week of March. It's time to worship. Come on, let's go into the house of the Lord. Right there in your bedroom, right there at your workplace, right there in your living room. I need you to go into the presence of the Lord with me. Is there anybody out there where the right says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his merciful kindness towards me. Is there anybody out there who's happy that we are yet in the land of the living? I need you to give thanks right there in Brooklyn. I need you to give thanks right there in Queens. I need you to give thanks right there in Manhattan. I need you to give thanks in Staten Island. I need you to give thanks right there in the boogie down Bronx. But I need you to take it further. For all my Ghanaian people who are watching this morning, welcome. For all my Caribbean people who's watching, welcome. For all my European people who's watching, welcome. But for anybody who's right here in Weeksville, who's watching this morning, oh, magnify the name of the Lord. Oh, open up your mouth and give him praise. Open up your mouth and give him thanks this morning. For the next hour, we have a wonderful service and we're going to go in. But I need you to call somebody. Let them know not only is God here, but the congressman is here this morning. Not only is the congressman is here this morning, we have some good musicians here for you. Not only is the musicians here this morning, we got some great singers here for you this morning. And I need you for the next 30 seconds. I need you to open up your mouth and bless the Lord. Somebody says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will continually be in my mouth. My soul will make its boast in the Lord. The humble will hear. Where are my elderly this morning? I need you to give God thanks and say, Lord, thank you for bringing me through my teenager years. Thank you for bringing me through my 20s. Thank you for bringing me through my 30s. Thank you for bringing me through my 40s, my 50s, my 60s, my 70s, my 80s, and I got a 93-year-old up in this church. Oh, magnify the name of the Lord. Is there about 200 of y'all out there who would just open up your mouth with an expression of praise in your living room? Oh, come on. It's go in the comment section right now and hashtag the phrase. It's time to worship. Open up your mouth in your living room. Open up your mouth in the hospitals. Open up your mouth in the bodega. Open up your mouth in your political office. Open up your mouth. Okay, we got to get a breakthrough. I need you to worship. Listen, bring that down for me for the next second. This morning when I woke up, I gave God thanks. And the next thing I did, I went on Siri. I said, Siri, how many more days until November the 3rd? And Siri says, 50 days. But we got to get a breakthrough in this country. Is there anybody who will get along with Siri and myself and say, oh, magnify the name of the Lord. Give thanks. Let us go into the presence of the Lord. We give thanks for his goodness and his mercy. You have so much to give God thanks for. If you're still here in the land of the living, when you look back over the last few months, from since March to April when this COVID was at its highest, when you're looking at the news and you see over 200 people have left this wonderful earth, I mean, you may be on unemployment, but you still have life. you still have an opportunity to change it around. And I don't want you this morning, I got a great message for you, but I want you in this moment as we pray to open up your mouth and say, Lord, in spite of what it looks like, I thank you. I need you to open up your mouth and say, Lord, in spite of the president we got, thank you. Lord, in spite of what they may do in Congress, thank you. Lord, thank you for whatever is happening in New York City, thank you. I need you to open up your mouth right there in your living room. I need you to talk back to us this morning. I need you to talk back to us this morning. And so, Father, we come before you in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, your Son. We're not perfect, but we come like David cried out in Psalms 51. Have mercy upon me, O Lord, according to your merciful kindness and according to the loving kindness of your tender mercies. Blot out our transgressions. Wash us that we may be clean. Cleanse us that we may be whiter than snow. Lord, for all of us out here who have broken hearts, broken homes, broken marriages, broken health, a broken workplace, a broken system, you are the God who is able to do it today, to repair it and to make it whole. I pray this morning for someone who had surgery, that you would now go into that room and heal their bodies. For somebody up here who does not have health care, we pray you will make a way. For somebody out here who's crying because of depression, because they've lost a loved one, they've been grieving all through these months, we pray that you may comfort them in this season. For pastors who are discouraged, not only here in Brooklyn, but pastors who are discouraged around this country, we pray that the spirit of comfort may come over them and give them new eyesight to see the promise of the Lord. We pray for political leaders that, Lord, you may give them the wisdom of Solomon, the wisdom to know to do the right thing for the right people at the right time, the wisdom to know that there are poor people who are suffering, the wisdom to know that they need, that we, your children, need help. We pray for someone who's suffering from AIDS, someone who's suffering from cancer, someone who's suffering from dementia, someone who's suffering from Alzheimer's, someone who's suffering from gout, someone who's suffering from a head disease, someone who's given up, someone who's overly depressed, someone who says, I can't take it no more, someone who just got the pink slip, someone who says, Lord, I now didn't think I was going to be here, but my husband left, my wife left, my daughter left, but they're crying out to you right now. Give them the encouragement that they need. Go forth, Lord, and Lord, break up the fallow grounds. Help them, Lord, to recover. And we pray for our congressman who's here, but you will endow him with the spirit of the Lord. The same way the spirit of the Lord came upon the leaders during the time of Moses, where the spirit of the Lord came upon them and they were able to do the work in an excellent way. We pray for him and his family. We pray for the leaders of Brooklyn, that you may guide and help them. We pray for all and everyone who's watching right now. Go into their workplaces, their living room, and in their personal setting. And would you give them the answers? We pray for the musicians. We pray for the singers. We pray for everyone who entered this space. Make it healthy. Make it clean by the Spirit of God. And we give you all thanks and all praise. In the wonderful name of Jesus, we pray. And somebody out there shout. You got to shout it, but you got to declare it. You got to declare it in this season. Hallelujah, you got to declare it in this season. You got to say, Lord, I thank you. You got to say, Lord, I thank you.
Father, you made
you gotta
God,
say, Lord, I thank you.
We worship you. Oh, Father, we adore you. You made a way. You
made a way.
When there was no way. Father, we need you, yes.
Yes, God.
Father, we need you, yes, to make a way.
Make a way.
In our lives, Jesus. On our jobs, Lord, make a way.
Make a way.
Please make a way.
Make a way.
Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. How many know that God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we could ever ask, think, or imagine? We just have to keep the faith and trust in Him. We're going to pick it up a little bit, guys. Oh, yeah, yeah. Exceedingly abundantly above all you could ask or think, according to the power that worketh in you. God is able to do just what He said He would do. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Don't give up on God, 'cause He won't give up on you.
See, He's able.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's able.
He's able.
Can we get a witness in the household today? Help me sing. God is able. God is able to do just what He said
He'll do.
Gonna fulfill.
He's gonna fulfill
every promise to you. Don't give up on God.
Don't give up on God.
'Cause He won't give up on you.
He's able.
Oh, 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 oh. Sing, He's able.
He's able.
Yes. Take it up, sing. Sing, God.
God is able to do just what He said He will do.
Gonna fulfill,
He's gonna fulfill
every promise to you. Don't give up on God.
Don't give up on God.
'Cause He won't give up on you.
He's able.
Oh, 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 He's able. Sing, oh, oh. Sing, He's able,
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 He's able.
God's not a man.
He's able.
God, He's alive.
He's able.
He's gonna fulfill His promise.
He's able.
And what is now?
He's able.
Yes.
He'll
pick you up.
He's
on your right.
He's able.
Place your feet on solid ground. He'll deliver you.
He's able.
He'll bring you through.
He's able.
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 Don't give up on God. 'Cause He won't give up on you. Help me sing. Don't give up on God.
'Cause He won't.
In the good times,
on you.
In the bad times, don't give up.
Don't give up
through the pandemic, through your trials, through your tribulations.
Don't give up on God, cause he won't give up on you.
I'm a living witness. Don't give up on God, cause he won't give up on you. He's able. Hallelujah. Let's give God some glory in the house on today. Father, we worship you. We adore you, Lord. You're worthy, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, we want to welcome the Lord into this place. We want to invite him into this house. Hallelujah, Jesus. The song says, welcome into this place. Oh, welcome into this broken vessel. You desire to abide in the praises of your people. So we lift our hands as we lift our hearts, as we offer up this praise unto your name. Come on, help me say welcome.
Welcome.
Come on, welcome Jesus into this place.
To this place.
Come on, say welcome.
Welcome.
Into this broken vessel.
Into this broken vessel.
Desire to abide.
You desire.
Would somebody open up your mouth and just bless the Lord? I said, would somebody open up your mouth? Shout back his name. Worship him from your living room. Worship him on your hospital bed. Open up your mouth and bless his. If you got the victory, I need you right now to take the next 10 seconds and shout victory. Somebody do a dance in your living room over there. Would you open up your mouth? Do it. 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 Worship him. I got to behave. The congressman is here. I don't want him to think that we're crazy up in here in Bethel Tabernacle. Amen. Wow. Thank you. Thank you. Outstanding singers. Thank you. Where's Brother Tony? Brother Tony? Tony had to come with an A-plus game today. Tony, that was just... Y'all go in the comment section and say thank you to Brother Tony. Brother Tony has been with me since for this pandemic and since day one. But someone asked yesterday while we were doing all this work up in the sanctuary, someone asked, how long have you and Brother Tony been together, as if we're in a relationship? But Brother Tony has been with me since my first church, and I give God thanks and praise for him. Amen. Amen. Just bring that down for me. For everyone who's listening, for the hundreds of you who will be watching this afterwards, just give me more feet on my mic, please. We are living in some times within this country that we need voices and leaders that will speak up. We need people who would stand against the grain and show and speak truth and show truth to power. We have one such leader in the house this morning. Ever since that he made that quote by Biggie, Notorious Biggie. And if you didn't know, now you know. After he speaks this morning, you will know who he is. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to call him brother. I'm proud to call him friend. The one and only Congressman Hakeem Jeffries. Would you please greet him from your living room? Come on now.
Pastor David Allen, we certainly are so thankful for you. We know you to be a mighty man of God, and we appreciate all that you do for the church and for the community. To the Bethel Tabernacle, Seventh-day, I'm thinking that I was in the SDA church for a minute.
You're fine.
To the Bethel Tabernacle AME Church family. I'm so thankful for you. It's an honor and a blessing to be worshiping with you on today. As some of you may know, I was raised in the Cornerstone Baptist Church, where I'm still a member to this very day. In fact, Pastor, I think my mother's looking for me right now. But whether we are AME, SDA, Baptist, Catholic, Methodist, we're all children of the same Father. Almighty God. In fact, the scripture says that unless the Lord watches over the city, the watchmen stand guard in vain. And we know that while it may be the government's job to perform, only Jesus Christ has the power to transform. And so it's a blessing to be amongst you right now. These are challenging times as we deal with the deadly pandemic, both a public health crisis and an economic crisis, and a lot of pain and suffering and death in the community, in the city, and in the country. It's an all-hands-on-deck moment. And so I continue to be committed to making sure that we can get the resources necessary to our community in order to make it through this storm. I'll be back in Washington tomorrow morning fighting for another round of direct stimulus payments of up to $6,000 per family, fighting for an extension of the $600 per week emergency unemployment insurance benefit, fighting for $175 billion so we can provide relief directly to renters and to homeowners. It's an extraordinary crisis. Our view is it requires an extraordinary intervention. And that's what we'll continue to fight for. Lastly, if I can be helpful to any of you directly, please don't hesitate to email me at congressmanjeffries08@gmail.com. congressmanjeffries08@gmail.com. Challenging times. And yes, we've got some challenges with the current occupant of 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. But as your pastor teaches us, even though we've got issues with him and his response, which has been an unmitigated disaster, the good news is God is still on the throne. He sits high and he looks low. And as long as we pray together and stay together and work and worship night and day together, one day soon, we will get the victory. God bless you, church.
Put your hands out there for the congressman. We need people like him who will speak truth to power and stand up against these times. We don't need a dictator in this country. What we need is a president. I'm going to say that again. We don't need a dictator in this country. What we need is a president. But in order to do so, you have to move. Somebody say hashtag move towards November the 3rd. You've got to do that census. I'm speaking to all my people of color especially. You've got to do that census and go do it now. You know me. I'm a big. I like to speak out on that census. It's so critical in this time. And the November 3rd, trust me, I'm going to be asking you consistently about this November 3rd until we get there. Amen. So thank you, Congressman, for being here this morning. I loved when he said he's staying for the whole service. We're trying to get him out of Cornerstone Baptist into the AME. I have some of my other political friends who say they go to, one was here, I know he's watching right now, somebody by the name of Carnegie who goes to Cornerstone also. But we love you all and we're one in the body of Christ. Amen. And so thank you so much, Congressman, for being here this morning. Thank you for those who came with him. God bless you. Thank you so much for your support here at Bethel Tabernacle. Every time we look forward to you, we ask that you continue to support us. It's simple. You can go to our website, which is www.BethelTabernacleAME/donate. www.BethelTabernacleAME/donate. You can also give by a variety of ways, which is Cash App, PayPal, Givelify. But you can also text the word give, to 716-226-5253. If you enjoyed what you saw this morning so far, would you sow into this ministry? Every other week, we're giving away bags and bags of food in this community. We want to make that much bigger. The kingdom of God propels us to do greater works in this time. And that's why you see these singers. That's why you see these musicians. And so we're asking you to go to our website, support this website, support the work that we're doing here. My wife and I have a great marriage ministry that you see now. You can see that on the website. You follow us for Tuesday's Bible study, but go to the website, www.BethelTabernacleAME.org. All right, we thank you so much. During this time, singers, thank you. Y'all bless me this morning. Y'all have one more song inside? All right, just before I preach. Sister Faye, where are you? Put your hands for Sister Faye. She blessed me all the time. And even though she lost a loved one just the other day, we keep her family in prayer as she comes to minister unto you. In the name of the Lord, amen.
He leads me beside still waters. Restoreth my soul. When you become a believer, your spirit is made right. And sometimes the soul doesn't get the notice. It has a hole in it due to things that's happened in the past, hurt, abuse, molestation. But we want to speak to you today and tell you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. Some people's actions are not because their spirit is wrong, but it's because the past has left a hole in their soul. May this wisdom help you get over your past and remind you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. I have my sister Leandria here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story.
Deliver me, 'cause all I seem to do is hurt me, hurt me.
This is my
this place. Oh God, we give you glory in this place. We don't know where we would be, oh God. If it wasn't for your strength, if it wasn't for your love.
Sing it.
We give you glory in this place. Yes, God, yes, God. Where would we be? Yes, God. So we thank him this morning for giving us strength. Hallelujah. The scripture says that his strength is made perfect in our weakness. And so we thank him this morning for his strength, for his love, for his joy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are my strength. Oh,
thank you, Jesus.
Strength like no other. Strength like no other. Reaches me. You are my strength. Yes. Strength like no other. Strength like no other. Reaches to me. Come on and say, you are my strength. Strength like no other. Strength like?
Strength like no other.
It reaches?
Reaches to me.
Say, you are my strength.
You are my strength.
Yeah, yeah.
Strength like no other. Strength like no other. Reaches to me.
Say in the fullness.
In the fullness of your
grace. In your power, Lord.
In the power of your name.
You lift me up.
You lift me up.
Oh, you lift me
up. You lift me up.
In the fullness.
In the fullness of your grace.
In your power, Lord.
In the power of your grace.
You lift me up.
You lift me up.
Oh, you lift me.
You lift me up.
You are my love.
You are my love. Love like no other. Love like no other.
And it reaches to me. Come on, we're gonna say that again. You are my love.
You are my love.
Oh yes, you are the greatest love. Yeah.
Love like no other. Love like no other.
And it reaches.
Reaches to me.
Come on, we gonna say in the fullness. In the fullness.
In the fullness of your
grace. In your power, Lord.
In the power of your
you lift me up.
You lift me up.
Higher and higher and higher.
You lift me up.
In the fullness.
In the fullness of your grace.
In your power, Lord.
In the power.
You lift me up.
You lift me up. voice. In your power, Lord.
In the power of your
you lift me up. He's the lifter of my head. You lift me up.
You lift me up.
Oh, with the fullness.
In the fullness of your
in your power, yeah.
In the power of your name.
You lift me up.
You lift me up.
In the fullness,
in the power of your name,
you lift me up.
You lift me up. You lift me up.
In the fullness,
in the fullness of your
name, in the fullness,
in the fullness of your
name, in the fullness,
in the fullness.
In the fullness,
in the fullness of your
grace. In your power, Lord.
In the power of your name.
In your power, Lord.
In the power of your name.
You lift me up.
You lift me up.
Oh, you lift.
You lift me up.
It reaches.
Reaches to me.
Say it reaches.
Reaches to me.
Say it reaches.
Reaches to me.
Say it reaches.
Reaches to me.
It reaches.
Reaches to me.
It reaches. Last time everybody reaches.
Reaches to me.
Oh, put your hands together and magnify the name of the Lord this morning. Oh, you can do better than that. Put your hands together and magnify the name of the Lord this morning. We got a short word for you. We got a short word for you today. And I give God thanks for Sister Faye and for these wonderful singers this morning who has blessed us. Let us pray as we go into the message for today. Father, we give you thanks and praise. We thank you that you're here with us already. It's very evident. We pray that you minister unto us. Let me speak to the logical person. But the way they process things will become very clear to them. And help me to speak to the emotional person that whatever they need to hear to get them to the next level. But you will do so. Let both the logical and the emotional person come together now. That you will be glorified at the end of this sermon. Help me to be clear. Help me to be transparent. And let your word touch every single person under the sound of my voice. In the wonderful name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Somebody say amen. Somebody out there says amen. It's a quick message. I want you to go to the book of Exodus. The book of Exodus. The book of Exodus. Thank you, Sister Faye, for that wonderful dance. I want to give a mention. Today would have been our missionary Sunday, and this house would have been packed. This house would have been packed with everybody in white. From different churches and our own. So I want to give a mention to Sister Donna, who more than ever regrets this pandemic, but thank you for the work that you're still doing. And so to all the missionaries out there, thank you for what you're doing still in this pandemic season. I thank you. God bless you. Amen. Exodus 14. I just want to read at least 10 verses just for your understanding of this particular scripture. Exodus 14 says here, "Then the Lord said to Moses, tell the Israelites to turn back and encamp near Pi-Hahiroth, between Migdol and the sea. They are to encamp by the sea directly opposite Baal Zephon. Pharaoh will think," pay attention to this verse, "Pharaoh will think the Israelites are wandering around the land in confusion, hemmed in by the desert. And I will harden Pharaoh's heart and he will pursue them. But I will gain glory for myself through Pharaoh and all his army, and the Egyptians will know that I am the Lord." So the Israelites did this. When the king of Egypt was told that the people had fled, Pharaoh and his officials changed their minds about them and said, "What have we done? We have let the Israelites go and have lost their services." So he had his chariot made ready and took his army with him. He took 600 of the best chariots, along with all the other chariots of Egypt, with officers over all of them. The Lord hardened the hearts of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, so that he pursued the Israelites, who were marching out boldly. The Egyptians, all Pharaoh's horses and chariots, horsemen and troops, pursued the Israelites and overtook them as they camped by the sea near Pi-Hahiroth, opposite Baal Zephon. Read verse 10 and 11. As Pharaoh approached, the Israelites looked up, and there were the Egyptians marching after them. They were terrified and cried out to the Lord. They said, "Moses, was it because there were no graves in Egypt that you brought us out to the desert to die? What have you done to us by bringing us out of Egypt? Didn't we say to you in Egypt, 'Leave us alone, let us serve the Egyptians'? It would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than to die in the desert." This is the verse of the day, verse 13. Moses answered the people, "Do not be afraid." Somebody say that with me. "Do not be afraid. Stand firm, and you will see the deliverance the Lord will bring to you today. The Egyptians you see today, you will never see again. The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still." Somebody said, "The Lord will fight." Y'all say that like y'all don't believe it. The Lord will fight. The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still. Amen. In this, I want to bring to you a quote from one of the greatest philosophers that I consider in written history, Ralph Waldo Emerson. Ralph Waldo Emerson made the quote, "When a resolute young fellow steps up to the great bully, the world, and takes boldly by the beard, he's often surprised to find it comes off in his hand, and that it was only tied on to scare away the timid adventurers." Church and everyone who's listening, we are in debt to history. When I say we are in debt to history, we have to understand that history happens to be the greatest teacher, congressman, that we've ever had. I'm going to say that again. History happens to be one of the greatest teachers that we ever had. History allows us to take what is presently happening and refer back to the past to make sure that we are on the right course. Can I say that again? History happens to teach us to take what is presently happening and look at what is happening now and compare it to the past. History is one of the greatest teachers, because history wants you to do a couple of things. History wants you to be aware. Just bring that down for me. History wants you to be aware of the wolves that can come in sheep clothing. History wants you to be aware of the mistakes that can happen repeatedly in your own personal lives. But history also tells you that you ought to watch what is happening within community. It tells you you ought to watch what is happening in the local boroughs of that's where you live. But it also tells you you ought to watch what is happening on a nation level. And when you don't do all of those things, you ought to pay attention to what is happening on a worldwide scale. History. And history will tell you that if you don't watch history, you're doomed to do what? Repeat the same mistakes that you have made. You ever been in a relationship and said, this person looked like somebody I've dated in the past. And they come back around because history taught you that you didn't learn the lesson that you had to learn. History tells us that those that we put in power, you ought to make sure that they have that compassion, that empathy towards people. History, because we don't want to repeat another Ivan the Terrible. History, we don't want to repeat what happened in Russia back in the days of all of those dictators. We don't want a repeat. History tells you to watch what is happening in the local, in your own local house with your children. You got to learn to love your children. You got to learn to love your family, because history tells you if you don't take care of your own, sooner or later they will rebel. History. And history tells us that we ought to look out for those leaders that we lift up thinking that they're the greatest ones, because they're the ones who can turn against us. And we see that right here in the book of Exodus. Exodus, we have a dictator right here in chapter 14. But you had to go back into Exodus 1 where the Israelites made a venture into Egypt thinking that it would be this great place. They worked. They became a part of the land. But sooner or later, just like a people, just like a certain people who were in prison working for 400 years, they gave free service. And Pharaoh became ungrateful. Pharaoh said, I want the most for less. You're going to give me every blood that you can give me. And you're going to do it by your own sweat and blood. And you got to, all you're going to really do it is by, I'm not even going to give you anything to make a brick. You got to work that out for yourself. I'm going to put you in these housing places and you're going to work it out for you. I'm going to take away Obamacare and you got to work it out for yourself. You got to work out healthcare. And when we look around, the stimulus is only $1,200 and you got, your expenses are $1,500. Where do you get the extra $300 from? And you're wondering why our young people have to resort to violence. You're wondering why there's an uptick in violence. Because they don't have the resources. And when there's no resources, people resort to violence. When there's no resources, people resort to the negative. When there's no resources, I can't help what the young people in my neighborhood would do. You tell them to take away the guns, but you don't put anything in their hand. You've got to do better than that. You've got to march towards the poll on November the 3rd and says, I am here, because history will not repeat itself. History would not make me be a fool. History taught me once. You bit me once, I will not be bitten again. Is there anybody out there that on this Sunday morning says, I will be the difference? And here's Moses. The people wanted to go back into Egypt. And usually when you're afraid, Congressman, when you're afraid, you want to go back and do what is comfortable. When you're afraid, you go back into relationship. You know the man didn't treat you right. But you say, I know the kettle is black, the pot is black. But I'd rather be in the black pot than in the fire itself. You know that man was beating you up. And you say, at least it's a slap, but he didn't hit me across the chest. And you become comfortable. The first point I want to give you before I get out of here is, here's Moses. The people started complaining because they want to go back into a place where they're comfortable instead of the change. Hear me, people. The first thing, do not be afraid. That's the first point. Listen here. Please get this point. Pharaoh and the promise is never compatible. Pharaoh and the promise is never compatible. The past and you going back to some old way of living back in the 60s when they try to, every time your color came around the corner, you had to answer to a different color. Now you don't want to go back. The past, which is Pharaoh, the past, which is Egypt, you don't want to go back. You got to move towards the promise of where God says you ought to be. Is there anybody, need about 500 people out there, who says right now, Pharaoh and the promise is never compatible. What I used to be and where I want to go is never compatible. My own relationship is not compatible with who I am becoming. Is there about 600 people out there who would go in the comment section and say, I am not afraid. I will move towards my promise. Hey, I will move. Somebody go in the comment section and say, I will move towards my promise. You got to move. You can't be afraid. And the reason why we're afraid is because, listen here, I get it. We're living in a time of the pandemic. You're afraid of the coronavirus. You're afraid of what this somebody who's living. I heard the congressman gave the address. But you're afraid of what they dump, of the dump that made in the Trump. In that place, you're afraid of what his next move is going to be. You're afraid of when every time you put on Fox News, there's a contradiction to what happened on CNN. You're afraid. And so you're afraid because now your boss is abusing you because he knows that 20 other people is waiting for your position. So you can't speak up in the workplace because you don't want to be on the unemployment line. You're afraid because you're living with somebody in your house who told you, just say one more time and the door will hit you where the sun never shines. You're afraid. You're afraid because the doctor told you this little lump that's in your chest, and before he can even finish the sentence, you start crying, thinking it's the end of the world. But I want somebody to get up and says, if God be for me, if God be for me, if God be for me, for me, if God be for me, who's? I need somebody up here to shout, who? I did a Negro that was saying that he can be against me. Who? I did. Did you say something? Negro? I dare you get up, because if God be for me, one can chase a thousand, but two can chase 10,000. But as long, I gotta behave myself. Moses look at them and he says, stand firm. Turn to somebody and say, stand firm. Your victory is around the corner. Stand firm. Listen here, it's a pandemic and you're afraid because you don't want to go outside. You talk to somebody these days, you don't know if they to shake their hand. You don't know to give them a bump fist. You don't know what to do. But God says, stand firm. When I read the news, it says that I was starting to think, here's the leader of one of the most powerful countries in the world. And people are giving their lives in war, the ultimate sacrifice. And he's calling them losers and suckers. I don't know if you read the news. I know some people of our own people say they don't read the news. They don't listen to the news. But when somebody given their ultimate sacrifice, and Pharaoh did the same thing, he says, watch Pharaoh. Pharaoh says, well, we're about to lose their service. He don't even care about their lives. He don't care about 200,000 people is dead. We're about to lose their service. If you can call the greatest sacrifice, people who gave the greatest sacrifice, suckers and losers, it's just a matter of time before you call the next ethnicity, the next group, the N-word. Okay, y'all not talking back to me. Y'all not talking back to me out there. And see, I told you that when I preach, I want you to get something that's going to move you to the next level. And here's this thing, if we don't speak truth to power, then power will feel as if they're the dictators of the land and what they say must go. You got to be careful of who comes into your life and who gets into power. That's what I was trying to start with. You got to be careful of who has the say in your life. Because sooner or later, you start saying, okay, I read something where they said the president said he didn't even think about what he was saying. The man never thinks about what he's saying. Hello, somebody. You've got to stand still and watch your deliverance. Because if you take your eyes off God, you will be looking at people who you think has the promise for you, but they only have a lie for you. But you gotta stand still on the grounds that you're standing on. And you gotta remind yourself that if God brought you out of Egypt, some people give up, Kim, because they look around, congressman, and all they see is a barren land. And if only all that you see is barren, you begin to give up. If you only have $5 in your pocket and the doctor says you need 10 for the copay, you begin to think that God gave up on you. But I need somebody that says the barren land is only a short distance to the promised land. Y'all didn't get that. The barren land is only a short distance to the promised land. I need somebody up in here to shout out, it's going to happen. If God says it, the promises of God are yea and amen. When I read Jeremiah 29, it says that the promises that God has for me, somebody read to me that God is not a man that he should lie. But is there anybody up in here? I didn't give you the sermon topic, but here's the sermon topic right now. What's popping? I got options. I say, what's popping? I got options. My option is I can go back to Egypt, but that ain't working for me. I keep my eyes on the promised land. What's popping? God is. I heard the word of Joshua. Joshua says, if you want, you go back over there. But as for me and Victoria and Anthony and Angelina, but as for me and my house, we will. Is there about 600 people out there that says we will? On November the 3rd, we will not give up. We will go to the polls. We will march forward. We will see a new morning. We will rise up. Rise up. Where my Caribbean people at? Rise. We done come again. Rise. Jay-Z said, turn it around. Bring that again. Get up. Rise. Is there anybody out there who can shout in the comment section, it's going to happen? I got to get out of here. First thing I want you to know, God will fight for you. Don't be afraid. The second thing is, stand firm, your deliverance. And I'm really done, Gerard. But I know a whole lot of people's gonna watch this. And congressmen, I get comments why I'm so animated. They send me all these comments on why you gotta act up so much in the pulpit. I got a whole bunch of pastors who's quickly leaving their church service because they want to see what Reverend Allen gonna say today. But when I was looking at this sermon, and I heard Sister Faye was dancing to that song. I heard the singers singing the song. And I realized that the congressman, I didn't even reach out to him. And I was joking with his staff saying, I don't even know how he remembered me. And I said, thank you. Preach with me, mother. I said, look at God. God will put you in certain places where it looks as if it's confusion. But God is saying, I got clarity for you. I got to get out of here. When I look at this particular text, there's a part one and part two, but in the end of verse, in chapter 13, it says that the angel of God, at night, the angel of God will lead them by a fire. And at night, at night he will lead them by fire, but by the day he will lead them by a cloud. But here's Pharaoh coming after them. And I was wondering, why would God leave his people in the middle between Pharaoh coming at them and the sea? It's like we say in today's contemporary times, God will put you between a hard place, a rock and a hard place. And we can't see the way forward. And we can't see our way back. We don't know which way to go. But at the end of this chapter 14, Congressman, it blew my mind. It says when the Israelites looked up, they saw the enemy approaching them. And you got to be very careful, because where God will place you, you will think that it's the end of your life. But God is saying, I strategically place you here. Because if you place yourself here on your own, you will think that it's you and your mistakes and your schooling and you did all this by yourself. But God says, no, I specifically place you here in the White House, in Congress, in your relationship, in school. I place you here in this church because for my glory. Because what I'm about to do will blow your mind. And it says when Pharaoh was coming, watch this, the angel of God moved from the front towards the back and became a divider between the enemy and the people of God. Watch this. Don't hear, that's not the shout. That's not the shout. The shout is when the Egyptians were looking, they saw only dark clouds and it was confusion for them. But the people of God, they saw forward and it was clarity. It was clarity for them. I came to tell somebody on my way out of this service, please excuse me for the extra 15 minutes that I took up, but I wanted you to be encouraged in your spirit. I wanted you to be empowered in your spirit. I wanted you to be enriched in your spirit. But God will bring confusion to your enemy and make your way very clear. Is there anybody out there that says, if God rises up, I don't have to do nothing? But be not afraid. The battle is not yours. The battle is the Lord's. Is there anybody out there? But I can shout like David, the Lord is my refuge and my strength, my very present help in the time of trouble. I'm not afraid because God is with me. I'm not afraid though sickness may come my way. I'm not afraid. Go in the comment section right now and I need you to shout, I am not afraid. I'm moving forward, for God is with me. I'm not afraid, for if he says yea, so shall it be.
if he says amen, better yet. But is there anybody out there that will lift up your hands and says, I know he is with me? Shout, 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 shout for your victory. Shout over your sickness. Shout for the win. I'm a winner. I'm a winner. I've got the victory. Shout. Shout for your children. Shout for your mother. Shout for your husband. Shout for your future. Shout it out. Shout. I got off.
This thing about the Word of God is that he wants you to realize you do have options. The options of evil, the option of good. In the theological world, we call it the theological emphasis of free will. God gives you that free will to choose. You've had many options. You can choose to give up and choose Egypt. What is Egypt? Egypt is, I'm just going to go along with it. I'm just going to give. I'm just going to just take what they give me. Egypt is, the doctor says I have cancer, so I'm not, that's just it. What am I going to find? Egypt is, that's what politicians do. So what? Why are you fighting them? That's Egypt. That's the country. I don't want to vote. No change. Every time I vote, do you see any change? Yes, I see change. For all my young people who's watching, here's the time that you can make a decision. The decision to move forward. You're the ones who's going to set history. Remember how I started off? You're the ones who's going to set the timeline of history. In a few years, I'll be old. Very much old. My wife is already calling me old. But you're the one who's going to change history and set it in stone. And you can do that right now by first accepting the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You have no power. You have nothing if you don't ask the Lord Jesus Christ to give you and to empower you to change your life. It's not about joining a church. No. It's about having a relationship with God. Secondly, this is for everybody who's given up out there because of what's happening with this pandemic. Don't be afraid. Look at me. Don't be afraid. Be encouraged. God is with you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this message. What's popping? I got options. And the options that we have is to be like Joshua. As for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord. The option to keep our eyes on you in spite of everything that is happening around us. The option not to give up, but to thrive on. Thrive on. Not to survive, but to thrive on. Not to throw hands up, but to thrive on. So be merciful. We thank you for your merciful kindness and your goodness. We pray for our congressman. Would you empower him? Would you strengthen him for these next couple months and for the remainder of his life? But he will be that lighthouse into this generation and others to come. But he will encourage those coming after him, his staff. But he will be the voice of change, the voice of liberty, the one you use. We pray for everyone who's listening, that someone who's not saved will receive you as their Lord and personal Savior. And we thank you. In the Lord Jesus Christ's name we pray. And everybody says amen.
We thank you for joining us here at Bethel Tabernacle. I wanted to go into the extension of this sermon because I wanted you to get it. Usually we end at 12, but we wanted you to get it today. Right now, the next couple months is so critical. I need you to be empowered. Because I know from speaking to the people in the community, they're discouraged. It will be a disservice for me to do a regular five-minute sermon and leave you in the place, in the desert, in Egypt, when you can be in the promised land. I want you to be empowered. I'm the Reverend Dr. Dave Allen. I love you. I love you. I'll see you next week, same time right here on the Bethel Tabernacle page. We love you, but we love God more. But we want you to have an enriched life. I'll see you soon. Thank you for joining us. See you next time. Take care now. Bye-bye now. Thank you for being with us. God bless you. Thank you, singers. Thank you, Brother Tony, Brother Gerard, Congressman, my brother, Franklin, Brother Omar, everybody else, Ronald, Faye, thank you. Praise God, I did call her name. The staff of the Congressman, thank you. God bless you. And for my wife who bought me this moshud, I'm looking totally moshud today. God bless you. Thank you, Mr. Moshud. God bless you. When I walk in his store, that man loves on me. God bless you. Thank you all so much. Take care now. We love you. God bless you. Thank you.